Hello to everyone listening Bahonesiteka. My name is Nadege Kibering. This video was produced in a partnership with Oasis Health. Today we are going to talk about antimicrobial resistance and get a general knowledge about it and encourage the best use of antimicrobial drugs among the general public, health workers and the policymakers to decrease drug-resistant infections. First of all, let us understand what is antimicrobial resistance. Antimicrobial resistance occurs when viruses, bacteria, fungi, and parasites change their genetic material over a period of time and are no longer susceptible to medicine that used to treat them. This will lead to hardly treatable infections and increase of severe illness, spread of diseases, and death. Antimicrobial resistance is a big concern to modern medicine. When we end up with no medicine to treat bacterial infection, surgical procedures will no longer be effective. People will severely die of infections. Antimicrobial resistance is dramatically increasing generally all over the world. Statistics shows that in some countries, more than 40% of infections are caused by bacteria that resist to antibiotics. In 2016, one quarter of healthcare facilities lacked basic water services and 21% did not have any form of sanitation. Then we are going to see the reason why antimicrobial resistance is increasing. The first one is the overuse and misuse of antimicrobials. This happens when antimicrobials are wrongly prescribed, shared, or used in excess. Health professionals may wrongly prescribe antibiotics to treat viral infections like colds and flu. As we know, antibiotics kill bacteria. When they are prescribed to treat non-bacterial disease, cause a long drug exposure to bacteria in the body, hence bacteria may learn how to resist that drug. Taking antimicrobials for a long time with no medical supervision and taking unprescribed or shared antimicrobials all lead to drug resistance. This microorganism keeps learning how to survive in the presence of such antibiotics. Overuse and misuse of antimicrobials in animals and agriculture also promote antimicrobial resistance. As in human, microbes in animals change over time and come up with a capacity that helps them to be resistant to current antibiotics. Those resistant infections spread among animals and may be passed to human directly from animals by contact or consuming uncooked animal products. The second reason is inadequate hygiene and sanitation. Inadequate clean water and sanitation and protected sexual intercourse, non-properly cleaned food lead to inadequate infection prevention. Statistics shows that 1 million sexually transmitted infections are acquired every day worldwide. Poor food hygiene can lead to potentially fatal foodborne diseases that may be untreatable and results in death. Ineffective infection control plays a key role in increasing the spread of drug-resistant infections in between people or animals. As Oasis Health said, hand hygiene is among the cornerstone of high-quality health care and one of the most effective ways of reducing the spread of antibiotic resistant organisms. The third one is COVID-19 and other common viral infections. During this time of COVID-19 outbreak, full of huge wrong information, people are using drugs wrongly, thinking that they may result into a cure of COVID-19. It happens where people take antibiotics after developing COVID-19 symptoms. COVID-19 is a viral infection. Antibiotics will cause no positive effect unless promoting resistance to the antibiotics being misused. After a prolonged use of these antibiotics, bacteria will need to deal with them. Once you get a disease from such bacteria, the same antibiotic will be ineffective against the organism. So, what can we do to prevent antimicrobial resistance? Well, Aziz Health gives three main advices to be employed as we fight this global health threat. These include infection prevention, improving drug prescription and distribution, developing new drugs and diagnostic tests, and generally raising responsible citizens. Through preventing infection, we need to improve sanitation, protected sex, proper food and hand hygiene are helpful measures to prevent either resistant or non-resistant infections spread. By avoiding infection, antibiotics to be given will decrease, and this will reduce risk to develop resistance during therapy. Drug-resistant infections can be prevented by immunization, safe food preparation, hand washing, and using antibiotics only when necessary. Second is to improve drug prescription. Perhaps the single most important action needed to greatly slow down the development and spread of antibiotic-resistant infections is to change the way antibiotics are used. Always use antibiotics appropriately and safely only when they are needed to treat disease, and to choose the right antibiotics and to administer them in the right way in every case. Oasis Health advises medical personnel to support community in applying responsible and safe antimicrobial usage. Medical doctors, pharmacists, and other involved health professionals should overlook for antibiotic usage. Make sure that they are prescribed when needed and if they are effective in treating the present infection. Third one is developing new drugs and diagnostic tests. Because antibiotic resistance occurs as part of natural process in which bacteria evolve, it can be slowed but not stopped. Therefore, we will always need new antibiotics to keep up with resistant bacteria, as well as new diagnostic tests to track the development of resistance. The fourth one is using antibiotics responsibly. Oasis Health said that antimicrobial resistance is a global health threat. It requires everyone's effort to win the battle against resistant microorganisms. Doctors may prescribe antibiotics accurately and the patients share them home. This will result in nothing. Health professionals, policymakers, and the general community should work together to prevent antimicrobial resistance from all corners. As we conclude our discussion about antimicrobial resistance, we thank you so much for being with us. As we have seen what microbial resistance is, how it is affecting our health, and how we can prevent it, so let us come together and stop the spread of resistant infections. This video was prepared by Wahune Steka in partnership with Oasis Health. Stay healthy.